Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the centroid of a plane region. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to find the centroid of the plane region that's defined by these four lines, x equals 0, x equals 4, y equals 0, and y equals 6. So let's go ahead really quickly and just graph these, since they're easy to graph and it'll give us a visual of our plane region. So we are looking at the lines x equals 0, which is the line here along the y-axis. We're looking at the line y equals 0, which is this line here along the x-axis. And then we're looking at x equals 4, so, you know, right about here, and y equals 6. So these are our four lines, and this is therefore our plane region, this rectangle here. And the centroid of a plane region is the coordinates of the center, the geometrical center of the region. So in the case of a rectangle, we can pretty much eyeball that. It's halfway between, obviously, the vertical sides, and it's halfway between these horizontal sides here. And, you know, there's this, if we draw diagonals through the center of the rectangle like this, you know, we know that our center is right about here. So the centroid is going to be the coordinates of that point. And the coordinates are written like this, x, y, with these lines over the top like that. So we need to find the coordinates of that point. And to find the x coordinate, we're going to be using this first formula here. To find the y coordinate, we're going to be using the second formula. And notice that in both formulas, we have a, right? And a is defined by this third formula over here. Notice that we have a equals. So the first thing we need to do is find a, and then take that and plug it into these equations for the x and y coordinates of the centroid. So to find a, we'll say a is equal to the integral. Notice that we have the integral on the range a to b, right? With an upper and lower limit, this is a definite integral. So you're just looking for the left end point and the right end point. And in this case, because we have a perfect rectangle, it's really pretty easy. We are looking for this point here, which is the leftmost point of the region, and this point here, which is the rightmost point of the region. Since we have the lines x equals 0 and x equals 4, we know that this point here is at 0, and this one is at 4, right? So we're going to be evaluating on the range 0 to 4. And then we're going to be evaluating f of x. Well, f of x is going to be the equation y equals 6. So we're just going to plug in 6 there, and then of course we have our dx. And the reason for that is because if this were another function, right, if we wanted to find the area under a function, right, a normal function, you know, would be something like this, roughly, you know, parallel to the x-axis, running horizontally like this, and, you know, we would define the range, right, 0 to 4, and then we would take this graph here. Well, the closest graph we have to that is this line up here, right? It's not going to be one of these vertical lines, x equals 0 and x equals 4, and it's not going to be y equals 0. So this line here, y equals 6, is what we want to use for f of x. We want to find the area underneath this line, y equals 6, on the range 0 to 4. That will give us the area of our entire rectangle. So that's why we plug in 6 to this integral here. And if we take the integral of 6, obviously we'll just get 6x. And we're going to be evaluating 6x on the range 0 to 4. So remember, with definite integrals, when we evaluate on a range, we plug in the upper limit first, which is 4. So we get 6 times 4. Then we subtract and plug in the lower limit, which in this case is 0, which leaves us with 24 minus 0, which of course is just 24. And that should make sense, because since we're dealing with a perfect rectangle, we have this line y equals 6, and we have this line x equals 4, and the other two lines are along the axes. So we know that the area of this rectangle is 24, because we can multiply 6 times 4, right? So we've kind of proven to ourselves that we can find the area of this rectangle using this formula over here. So the area is 24, and now we can go ahead and plug it into our our formulas for the x and y coordinates. So to find the x coordinate, we'll get 1 over 24 by the formula here, and then we'll take the integral again from 0 to 4 of x, which is part of the formula, times f of x, and again we're going to call f of x the equation y equals 6. This is going to be f of x in every case, so we're going to multiply by 6, and then we've got dx. So this ends up being 1 over 24 times the integral of 6x. Well, the integral of 6x is 3x squared, and we're going to be evaluating that on the range 0 to 4. So let's first go ahead and simplify 1 24th times 3x squared. When we do, we'll get x squared over 8, and this is now what we can easily evaluate on the range 0 to 4. Again, we plug in 4 first, the upper limit, and we'll get 16 over 8. Then we'll subtract and plug in 0. We get 0 over 8. So we can see that that's just going to be equal to 2. This is going to become 0. 16 over 8 is just 2. So the x coordinate is 2, right? So we'll go ahead and write that down. And now we need to find the y coordinate. So again, y equals 1 over 24 times the integral from 0 to 4. 1 half is part of the formula there. So we leave that in there, and then f of x again will be 6, but according to the formula, we need to square that, right? So we square it, dx is part of our notation. So now we can just go ahead and solve this integral. When we simplify what's inside the integral, we get 36 over 2, which is just going to be 18 dx. Taking the integral of 18 gives us 18x, so we end up with 1 over 24 times 18x, and then we're going to evaluate on the range 0 to 4. We can simplify 1 24th times 18x. We'll get 3x over 4 evaluated on the range 0 to 4. We'll plug in our upper limit first. So 4 times 3 gives us 12 over 4 minus 3 times 0 is 0 over 4. This obviously just becomes 0, and 12 over 4 is equal to 3. So that is our y coordinate. So the centroid of our plane region is, again, remember this coordinate here, right, which we get from the formula, and we know that that's going to be equal to 2. 3, and that's our final answer. And a final point, this should make sense in the context of this particular problem, because our problem is our plane region is a rectangle, right? So we already know the center, right? If we go halfway between the x boundaries here, 0 and 4, halfway across would be 2, right? So the x coordinate we already know to be 2. And if we go from 0 to 6 on the y-axis, halfway would be 3. So we could have eyeballed this just by looking at it, and we would have known that the coordinate of that point was 2, 3. But these are the formulas that you would use to prove it, and certainly if you had a more complicated problem, you would need these formulas. But that's it. That's our final answer. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!